Welcome back to the course, Introduction to Analyzing Big Data in R using Apache Spark. In this lesson, lesson 3, we're going to be looking at machine learning in Spark R. The aim of this lesson is to understand machine learning and also how to use the GLM or generalized linear models within Spark R. Within Spark R for machine learning, we have Spark MLlib. This is a module, library, and extension of Apache Spark to provide distributed machine learning algorithms on top of Spark's RDD abstraction. Spark ML is a module to provide distributed machine learning algorithms on top of Spark data frames. There's a distinction between the two there. A machine learning algorithm takes data as input and it produces a model of that data as output. This model can then be used to make predictions out of a variety of data sets. Machine learning uses large data sets to identify or infer patterns and make decisions. This automated decision making is what makes machine learning so efficient at predicting future events and trends. Machine learning workflow involves using test data to evaluate various models until the best model is found, and this can then be applied to the production data. An observation is used to learn about or evaluate an item's target value. Spark models observations as rows in a data frame. A feature is an attribute of an observation. Spark models features as columns in a data frame. MLlib is Spark's machine learning ML library. Its goal is to make practical machine learning scalable and easy. It consists of common learning algorithms and utilities, including classification, regression, clustering, collaborative filtering, dimensionality reduction, as well as low-level optimization primitives and higher-level pipeline APIs. It is divided into two packages, MLlib and ML. Spark MLlib contains the original API built on top of RDDs. Spark ML provides a high-level API built on top of data frames. Spark ML standardizes APIs for machine learning algorithms to make it easier to combine multiple algorithms into a single pipeline or workflow. Using Spark.ml is recommended because with data frames, the API is more versatile, flexible, and faster. So we will concentrate on ML in this lesson. A pipeline is specified as a sequence of stages, and each stage is either a transformer or an estimator. These stages are run in order, with the input data frame being transformed as it passes through each stage. Let's look at the concepts in pipelines. Firstly, we have the data frame. Spark ML uses the data frame from Spark SQL as an ML dataset. This can hold a variety of data types. For example, a data frame could have different columns storing text, feature vectors, true labels, and predictions. Next, we have the transformer. A transformer is an algorithm which can transform one data frame into another data frame. For example, an ML model is a transformer which transforms data frame with features into a data frame with predictions. An estimator is an algorithm which can fit onto a data frame to produce a transformer. For example, a learning algorithm is an estimator which trains on a data frame and produces a model. A pipeline is a chain of multiple transformers and estimators, which together specify an ML workflow. Finally, we have a parameter. All transformers and estimators now share a common API for specifying parameters.